look like tough guys. Thug life, tough guys. Where you gonna go? Do you like the way? Now you gotta lay low. Thug life, tough guys. Where you gonna go?
Pike Place Market is one of my favorite places for speeders to hop in, especially at night. Look, and here's two now, like I said. I'm giving you a ticket. They told me to stop writing these out.
Treat it like a moving violation, because you were moving, and that's a violation on the sidewalk at that speed.
I mean, you guys are doing like 12, 11 miles an hour. I don't know, but I mean, you don't look bad.
No, I'm all right.
So I want you to treat this like a real ticket.
We'll do.
All right. Have a good night.
Here in Seattle at Key Arena for the LG Action Sports World Championships. Right behind me is the street course where the men's street inline finals are going to go down. Now we've got the Prince, Brian Aragon, here in search of his first world championship title. But in order to get it here in Seattle, he's going to have to go through a determined field, including young upstart David Sizemore out of Georgia. But it's a new course and a new format, so all bets are off as we work our way to men's street finals.
Thanks, Arlo. The Best Trick Jam format began with 25 skaters, but now only our top 12 remain standing. The semifinals featured two heats of the top six skaters on the planet. Heat number one is stacked. Jeff Stockwell, Richie Velasquez, Stefano Fano, Brian Aragon, Dave Sizemore, and Chaz Sands. Here we go with Jeff Stockwell, first attempt on the day.
Yes, and this is a brand new format for the championships. Instead of a two-run format, these guys are doing best trick session style. You see, Jeff Stockwell started out with that transfer up to the disaster topside misfit, now he's topside mistrial. Nice trick.
And don't be confused by all the skating from obstacle to obstacle. It's really based on only your best trick, but this course sort of conducive to a lot of setup.
Yeah, and you know, the judges were instructed to go by an overall impression for the session format, but there is a little more structure to it. It's not just an open session, as you can see, and as you've mentioned, the guys will go in order, one at a time. That's to keep the course clear for their safety and also to avoid kind of the chaos that comes along with a session. So the spectators and the judges can clearly see what's going on. And it works out. Yeah, very cool. He goes 450 to alley-oop sole transfer up on the vert quarter pipe.
Big banger for Stefan Alfano, one of the most consistent traditional contest skaters as well, but here already putting something in the books.
And this format is fair to the skaters as Aragon goes 900 because they all get the same number of attempts. Even as time winds down at the end of the session, they will make sure that each skater gets a last attempt, so it won't end in the middle of a session. Everybody gets the same number of attempts. It's a really nice format, and I'm really happy to see it here in the finals.
Young Dave Sizemore going for the crowd pleaser. Big backflip acid drop from the top of the box down onto the flat.
And you can hear him. The crowd was definitely pleased, so they got what they came for.
And again, as somebody goes for a trick, if they fall on another trick, not their best trick, it really doesn't matter. Falls don't count. It only counts that you land your biggest and best trick. Here we go, Chaz Sands out of Glasgow, Scotland, going for the big launch over the spine. Unfortunately, that's not going to count for him. Some incredible tricks already from Stefano Fano, Brian Aragon, Dave Sizemore, and we are just getting started. Much more when we come back.
The LG Action Sports World Championships is brought to you by LG. Life's good. By Maxell, official sponsor of the Action Sports World Tour. By NPPL Championship Paintball 2009, bbsting.com. And by BFD.com. The biggest names in action sports are at BFD.com.
Welcome back to Seattle, Washington. We are inside the Key Arena. It's the LG Action Sports World Championships. And we've got Inline Street Mayhem going on.
Talk to me a little bit about your run.
I don't know, just try to keep it consistent, try not to fall, and just make it look good, I guess.
If you were a gambling man, who would you put your money on in this contest?
Frankie Morales.
Frankie's looking good?
Yeah, he's the man, he's the man.
Referencing Frankie Morales, who is in the next heat, but in qualifiers did very, very well. Jeff Stockwell, the first up here in this heat, already has done one pretty impressive trick. They're having some trouble, though, and going down in attempt number two.
Yeah, and consistency doesn't matter in this format. It's really all about style, creativity, and difficulty. If you land it, the judges can score it.
The first major competition where this format was brought out was during the Gravity Games a few years ago. Our last skater, Richie Velasquez, actually won that event, so he is definitely a veteran and a big fan of this format. Stefano Fano stepping it up.
450 backside Farfig Nugent transferring up onto the sub box. His legs got kind of weird on the landing, but he did stick it and rode it out.
Here we go with Brian Aragon, one of the most dominant street skaters in the world. Oh.
Interesting transfer. He did a little torque fast plant off the hitch and post. Tried to jump over the hip transfer in a unique way. David Sizemore has been making quite an impression throughout the qualifiers and now here in this semifinal heat. And you can see there the problem with the handrail and its location. He did the handrail, he did a 450 backside Royale, but then there's really nowhere to ride out of it. He went straight into another ramp.
But I love his approach. He already landed the backflip. Then he went for something completely different, something much more technical.
That's right. There is a lot of strategy that goes into this kind of session format. Remember, this is only the semifinal heat, so there's still one more heat to go. So these guys have to show enough to make it into the next round, but at the same time, they might be holding something back for the final round. So it's a thin line that they walk. Jeff Stockwell going down, now setting up for Richie Velasquez.
Richie having some trouble. He has yet to really land one big banger out here. And up against the likes of Brian Aragon and Stefano Fano, some of the stuff that these guys have already landed, he's got his work cut out for him now.
Yeah, big flat spin, 540 from Stefan. And he goes 270 backside Royale up on the sub box. He's been cruising around the course. That run in particular, that attempt, I should say, didn't really have any huge bangers. And that's what we're looking for here, is the big trick, the one that's going to get you into the next round.
I think Brian Aragon not only lands everything and makes it look so easy, but he's got so much style. The judges notice that.
Yeah, and also you'll notice there's some guys that, like Aragon and Stefan in particular, who've done big things over the box. We've seen 900s and flat spins, and also have done some difficult grinds with the 360 transfer to topside sole. And that kind of balance will help you to get you through to the next round, because remember, it is still an overall impression.
But Chaz Sands has quietly been landing a couple of really decent tricks.
Point
there. Yeah, a little 450 transfer, flat spin style from the transition to the wedge. The pressure is on Jeff Stockwell.
Yeah, this is their last chance to make an impression on the judges and make sure that they've got a spot secured in the final six. There will be one more heat after this.
Tough break for Jeff Stockwell. You know, he definitely skated with his signature style, but there wasn't one big memorable best trick.
Right. And here's Richie trying to get pumped up. And that, you know, that hitching post is deceptive. It is overhead high. So, it looks like they're just working on stalls up there. But as you can see demonstrated by Richie, when you go down, it's still going to take a pretty good hit. Stefan Alfano, creative line as he goes frontside royale across the hitching post.
Depending on how strong the next heat is, Stefan Alfano is probably a lock to make it into the top six.
Yeah, he's had a good session here, as has Brian Aragon. Flat spin 360 over the box, topside soul to 540 back in. Nice way to end it for him.
I'd say Prince Aragon is a definite lock.
And I have to say, David Sizemore has been pretty impressive in this round, too. I know that he's got to be one of the crowd favorites, but I think that the judges also have appreciated the stuff he's done well.
Gotta love a backflip from about 10 feet up.
Yeah, if you're going to do a backflip, you may as well do it from about 10 feet up.
And last chance for Chaz Sands to do something and stay with the judges.
Flat spin 720 over the box. And I heard a lot of skaters talking about, Mark, how difficult it was to get speed from that launch box. So just one more thing to keep in mind when you watch guys like Chaz doing those big 720s and 900s over that box.
A great first six skaters taking the course. Brian Aragon, one of the favorites here after that performance, and Catfish is with him now.
Talk to me a little bit about your run. Well, that was my first heat skating right there, and it went pretty good. It seems like usually when you do these jam style, once you get a couple tricks down, it kind of starts flowing, you get your confidence up, and you can kind of build from there.
How much do you favor the jam format as opposed to 60-second runs?
Well, I favor it. I think it just shows people's real skills instead of just, like, staying conservative, and I think the crowd really enjoys seeing the people throw it all out there, too.
Awesome, Brad. Thank you so much.
Some rockin' skating so far, and on the Maxell Music Stage, more rock and roll with MXPX. Welcome back to Seattle, Washington, and the Key Arena. It's the LG Action Sports World Championships. Some people sit back and go through the motions of life. Others live to the fullest. That's why one of today's favorite skaters, Frankie Morales, is featured as Paul Mitchell's Runs with Scissors profiled athlete.
I mean, long story short, Jason pretty much saved my life.
It was back in 95, 96-ish, right around there, and just a bunch of little, ratty, dirty kids that were hanging out at the skate shop I worked at back in Miami Beach. And they seemed like good kids, but just with no direction. And Frankie was the oldest one out of the children that used to hang out there.
I was just like a little kid, just with the wrong crowd and just doing bad things. I actually met Jason stealing from a shop from him, stealing wrist guards. Well, I wasn't, my friends were, but I was there, so.
He came into the shop and told me, hey, I've got to talk to you about something, and pulled me out front. So we went outside and he had all the other little kids lined up there. He's like, hey, that's not cool, why'd you do it? And his cousin said, oh, well, we want skates too, but we don't have the money for it. And Louis Bonilla, who's one of the ramp crew guys, and he said, well, if you guys want to do it, then you have to earn it. We'll get you skates, we'll get you everything, but you have to put in the time, skate, and do right with it.
So we kind of like gave him the opportunity to be like, come, we'll teach you. And you gotta be, you gotta leave that stuff behind, all that stuff behind. And from there on, we got them skates, and then I started taking them out, skating the ledges and stuff like that.
He basically gave us free skates, me and my little brother, and just kept us on the right place. it was really cool just to put on skates and just get back and forth instead of catching the car so I could just weave through traffic. It first started going down garages and, you know, holding onto cars and then started grinding and then took off from there.
So we kind of see how he was improving. And from then on, we kept going with him and keep taking him to like events and competition.
It was in 97 when the big contest, which was the ASA World Tour back then, that was the first time that, you know, any of us had been exposed to a contest that big.
Frankie Morales, I'm really looking forward to watching him. The kid's just, he's unstoppable. He's another Salerno.
And from there, you know, his career started skyrocketing.
Frankie Morales is smooth, sweet, thinner.
And then we knew that he was going on the right path because he just dedicated himself to say, I could do this.
Jason was just like that one big brother that kept me in school, put some clothes on my back when my mom couldn't afford it, and just like taught me a whole lot of stuff. So, you know, I appreciate that a lot for sure.
Him and I don't see each other that much anymore. I know that he knows we still care about him, and I mean, just we're proud of him.
I am happy for Frankie, big time. It's like, when he rides, it's like me riding, because I know that it's not easy.
I mean, I changed like 100%. Just, I mean, I still got like my habits, you know, my tattoos and like my look and my whole image and whatnot. But I definitely opened a lot of doors up, and especially for the urban people, and like they can also do skating, you know what I mean? Because somebody like me doesn't.
Since those early days in Miami, Frankie's come a long way, and he is arguably the favorite out here on the street course.
Also competing against Frankie Morales, Eric Bailey, Ryan Arnold, Brian Shima, Nicholas Schelfer, and CJ Wellsmore. Eric Bailey, one of the best out here.
Yeah, going Alley Top Acid up on top of the sub box. He is one of the best. In fact, he's a former world champion. He's won the Action Sports World Championships before. And in fact, someone who has won the world championship several times before, in fact, the reigning world champion, oh my goodness, Ryan Arnold going down hard, pouncing up quick, brushing it off. Chris Haffey, I was going to say, is a former world champion. He won this event last year, but he did not make it out of the prelims. So quite a shocking development.
Well, it shows just how competitive it is out here as well. You have to be very creative, and you got to make the most of your attempts because you don't get that many.
That's absolutely right. You have to be very creative because this is a really different course for these guys. So the ones who are able to figure out the best lines on it and make the most of it are the ones who are doing the best here this afternoon.
What's truly interesting is you've got guys like Nicholas Schelfer and CJ Wellsmore. Here we go with Frankie. Everybody's been talking about him.
Boom.
And you can see why right out of the get-go.
Yeah, going fakie off the top of the deck up there on that vert quarter pipe, and then he goes basically acid drop into the transition, fakie 720, and that's the first trick we've seen that really, I think, stands out. It's unique, it's creative, high difficulty. I mean, that's one that'll wake you up and get the judges' attention.
Wow, great amplitude here. And this is what I was saying earlier. CJ Wellsmore and guys like Nicholas Schelfer are used to skating at events like the Asian X Games where the courses are smaller, and they really know how to make the most of what they've got.
And certainly know their way around a transition. CJ just blasting off of those quarter pipes.
Back to the top of the order, Eric Bailey missing there, trying to lock on.
Yeah, trying to go 360 to sweat stance up on the sub box.
Well, that was the one he fell on the first time around. We'll see if, what else he's got. He's gone down twice now, though, but that fall doesn't affect his score.
That's right, because he landed that flat spin big and clean over the box, so it doesn't really matter that he fell the trick after it.
Ryan Shima, one of the most creative skaters in the world, both in his video parts and during competitions, showing why right there. The show for making the most of the course again, trying different things every time he takes to the course.
Yeah, and there's a lot of different strategies. You know, for every different rider, there's probably a different strategy. Some guys are going to try and hit one hammer. They might invest a lot of time into it. Another guy like Nick might cruise around the course and try a whole bunch of different things. 360, topside, sole, then fakie into the quarter pipe. Very smooth and stylish from Frankie.
Frankie is so talented. He's already now landed two different, very different types of tricks. I can see why the other skaters are all saying he's the guy to look for.
I love the amplitude coming out of CJ Wellsmore. Bam, going huge abstract 720 transfers.
Oh, looks like he hurt himself a little bit there. Let's hope he's gonna be around for the next set of tricks. We finish off yet another group, and before we go to the top of the order, we're gonna take a break here from Key Arena. When we come back, more semifinal action and a look at the women's finals here on the street course.
Attention all units, this is the LG Action Sports World Championships.
Welcome back to Seattle, Washington. It's the LG Action Sports World Championships and the Key Arena. One of the keys to success in action sports is landing big tricks. That's exactly what Chris Haffey does here in this LG Trictionary.
I'm Chris Haffey, and this week's Trictionary is an alley-oop unity. The way that I do it, depending on which foot you do it with, I would approach with the rail on the left, and you jump and put your front foot in like a front torque position, but swing your back foot around that foot and put it in a royal position. So you're just doing basically a unity, but backwards, so that's why it's alley-oop unity. That was this week's Trictionary. It was an alley-oop unity, and go try it out.
You can see more Trictionaries as well as behind the scenes footage on the Top Pros, video from the biggest events, the craziest tricks, and the biggest wrecks, all at bfd.com. Check it out. Ryan Arnold, our next skater up here in the middle of this heat. Six skaters all trying to land their biggest, craziest stunts here for the judges, and only the top scores will advance to the final round of six. Ryan Arnold's been spending about an equal amount of time on his back as he has on his feet. Three big attempts and three times he's ended out on his back now.
Now there's something really interesting I think that Shima's going for on that hitch and post. I saw him trying it earlier. He tried to do a little wall ride on the side of the 2x4. Really interesting.
Nicholas Schaffer having a little bit of trouble. You know, he hasn't done that one big banger. And remember, Stefan Alfano, Brian Aragon, Dave Sizemore, and frankly, Chaz Sands all had some incredible tricks in the last heat.
And now look at this. Frankie Morales up on the vert ramp, completely out of the street course, and he's jumping back in. 180 transfer, wow.
That was a large free fall to that low transition.
Wow, that was a huge trick from Frankie. And remember, earlier in this session, he had the other standout trick, the fakie 720 into the quarter pipe. So Frankie trying to run away with this thing right now.
Well, his work is already done. All he really needs, now, CJ Wellsmore, the other guy out here who's really got a ton of amplitude. We'll see if he's got something here. Remember, he kind of hurt himself the first time around, and here going down again. Pretty durable skater though, CJ Wellsmore. He's only 20 years old, so he's got the energy.
You know, it's too bad though, because CJ is definitely one of the standouts in this round, but he's got to land it in order to advance, and he's just not landing enough.
Eric Bailey also having some trouble out here though.
Yeah, you get as many attempts as you can fit into the 10-minute session, but you got to land something somewhere in order for the judges to give you some kind of score to advance you. So Brian Arnold still having trouble here in this round. There he goes, rocket 540 over the hip.
Brian Shima directing traffic, making sure the course is clear. I love the creativity. Didn't really get much of a wall ride on that. He put his other foot down, but he's already nailed that beautiful wall ride across that beam.
360 acid.
And as we get close to the end of the heat, you're seeing guys starting to finally put their tricks together. What else can Frankie Morales do? He's already nailed three big bangers.
Yeah, well, there's a cool one. Pretty safe to say Frankie's already got a spot saved for him in the final heat. So he'd do well to save a little bit for the final round. But CJ Wellsmore, on the other hand, has got to land something, land one of these big tricks he's been attempting if he's going to make it into the finals.
Here we go again, Eric Bailey. These guys really cramming a lot more tricks in, even more than the last heat, because they're just going, going, going. Not a lot of delay between each trick here.
definitely a more frenetic pace here in this heat. And you know what I think is going on, part of it. In the first round, in the first heat, I should say, there are a lot of guys that did a lot more line skating, whereas these guys are staying pretty closer to the pure concept of the best trick contest.
Ah, Ryan Arnold, frustrating day for him. He keeps falling down. He's doing some big, impressive tricks, but ending out on his backside almost every time.
Oh, yeah. That was it. Cool.
I'd say he's about a lock as well. So the two standouts to me, Brian Shima and Frankie Morales. We'll see if anyone else has got something as we come to the end of this heat.
Well, and you know, once again, it goes to show you, I mean, Brian Shima and Frankie Morales have really illustrated this point that creativity is what's going to stand out in this course.
Well, creativity and sheer guts as far as Frankie goes.
Right, but what I mean is they've both found a unique way to use this course that is dynamic and dangerous and impressive, as you mentioned, but it is just something different to stand out. Frankie left the course, and Brian with the wall ride using that pigeon post in a totally unexpected way.
CJ Wellsmore is fast running out of time. He's getting so close on some of these tricks, but none of them are real standouts.
But most of the standouts that he's done, he just hasn't landed. So it'd be a real shame if CJ doesn't make it into the final heat. But right now, I'm not sure that he has enough.
Well, this is it. This is everybody's last attempt. Eric Bailey missing there. Ryan Arnold has had a tough time of it, and he ends out yet again with a big crash. He had enough to make it to the top 12. Doesn't look like he's going to make it into the final six.
Brian Shima trying a true top sole attempt up on the hitch and post, but he already got the trick he wanted there, so he's gonna hope that that would be enough to get him into the final round. Here comes Nicholas Schauffer for his last attempt. There's a creative line. Too bad he didn't start trying that one earlier. That was cool. 540 over the ledge, all the stairs, all the way down the flat.
Frankie Morales really just waved his hand at this point and said, I don't need another one, but that's not his style. Going all the way to the buzzer. Here we go. Come up to our last skater, CJ Wellsmore. The pressure is on the 20-year-old.
How difficult is something like that gap you did in that corner?
I mean, I've been doing that for a while. That's like one of my signature tricks. I like jumping in gas, stuff like that. So, I mean, it's pretty hard, but it was good.
How big of an influence does the crowd play in your skating?
Oh, man, the louder they get, the bigger I go. You already know.
Who do you think is looking good out here?
Oh, it's tough, man. CJ's looking real good. Brian Aragon, Jeff Stockwell.
Everybody's saying you.
Oh, man, I don't know. I guess, yeah.
We're going to have to wait and see.
Right?
Great skating, man.
Appreciate it.
Thanks.
The final's still to come, but now let's take a look at how it went down in the women's competition here on the street.
It was a tough contest featuring the best women skaters from all over the world. China Weirstall made it into the finals. The young competitor out of Roseville, Michigan, fresh off of her S3 Supergirl Rail Jam victory in Huntington Beach. And she showed some more of that technical proficiency that she showed off in Huntington Beach and landed her spot in fourth place in the finals against the best women in the world. No one could match the difficulty of China's grinds, but at the end of the day, it was her low consistency score that kept her out of a podium spot. Fabiola DaSilva followed up her momentum from her third place finish in the vert finals against the men with another third place on street against the best women in the world. Out of Sao Paulo, Brazil, Fabiola showed that she is multi-talented, not just a threat on vert, but also a formidable competitor on street. Fabiola has taken her extensive knowledge of vert and really excelled on the transitions, flying over all the hips and obstacles. Fabiola was able to take her unique skill set and skate into a third place finish, picking up her second medal here at the LG Action Sports World Championships. Former world champion Fallon Heffernan fell just short of making it her second world championship title. But with Fallon's unmatched combination of big air tricks and difficult grinds, She was able to skate her way into a second place finish to add to the hardware she has been amassing over the years. Always a top threat in any street contest, Fallon earned the respect of her peers. But it was Jenna Downing's day. The young lady from Barnsley, England, dominated the competition from start to finish, putting together two stellar runs and mixing together an unmatched arsenal of air tricks and grinds. Hitting every obstacle on the course, Jenna Downing earned her first LG Action Sports World Championship title. So a big congratulations to Jenna Downing and all the female competitors, showing once again why they are such an important part of inline skating.
Jenna, you skated amazing all weekend long, came out on top. How's this win feel?
Oh, it just feels so amazing. I'm so happy because I really tried my hardest in all my runs and really pushed it as much as I can. So, well, it just feels the best.
You guys are such an inspiration to all the girls out there. There's millions of girls watching you right now. What words of advice do you have for any females out there that are interested in aggressive inline?
They just really need to get out there and have a go. You know, not be scared. Just don't be intimidated. Have a go, get involved, and they'll get so much out of it. It's the best feeling. So
awesome. Well, awesome. Well, congratulations.
Thanks a lot.
Ramp works!
We've gone from 25 down to 6. Brian Shima, Chaz Sands, Brian Aragon, Dave Sizemore, Stefan Alfano, and Frankie Morales will battle for the World Championship title when we come back.
The LG Action Sports World Championships have been brought to you by LG, Life's Good. By John Paul Mitchell Systems, and not just what you do, it's how good you look doing it. Paul Mitchell, Style Points County. By Xbox 360. And by ASA Entertainment. We are Action Sports. Visit asaentertainment.com.
Do you like the jam format?
Yeah, it's good, you know, for the crowd because it lets them see the biggest and best tricks that inliners can do, not just of the conventional lines runs where everything just has to be consistent so everybody maybe plays it safe. In this kind of format, you can fall, but then get up, try again. You can bust some big stuff, so.
What do you think about the crowd out here? There's a huge crowd watching you guys skate.
Yeah, it's great, you know, like sometimes there's not big crowds coming to visit, but this is a good crowd, you know. It's great for them all to be cheering for everybody, and yeah, they're great.
And Stefan Alfano will kick things off here in the final round. Same format. Now we are going to crown ourselves a world champion.
Yeah, and if anybody's been holding anything back throughout any of the preliminary rounds or the semifinals, now's the time to unleash it all. Here comes Brian Aragon with his first attempt as he goes 900 over the box.
And you can see how things are a little bit more methodical. Everybody wants to get that one big banger in, and then they'll move on to another box and try something new.
That's right, trying to give the judges something to score right out of the gate to free them up a little bit, to take some chances as this session develops.
Dave Sizemore there with a 900 over the box, but not huge amplitude. Still, one of the bigger tricks you're gonna see over the launch box, so at least he's got one in the can.
Especially given the circumstances with that short run up, hard for the skaters to get a lot of speed to that launch box.
Chaz Sands going for a 720, a strange slow rotation. Couldn't get it around, get his feet back down. Here we go, Brian Shima. Most likely going back in that creative line that worked for him in the qualifying.
There he goes. Oh, actually even trying to raise the stakes on that, going from the wall ride on the side of that 2x4 and then trying to drop down to Seoul. Very ambitious trick from Brian Shima.
And by far the crowd favorite, Frankie Morales, did so many big stunts. We'll see what he's going to kick off with.
Wow. 900 over the hip, nice variation on that 900 rotation. We've seen a lot of guys throw 900 over the box. Nice way to mix it up from Frankie, who's definitely been the star of this contest so far. Whoa! 1080 from Stefan Alfano.
This is what it's all about, a little one-upmanship here. Everybody has to keep stepping it up each attempt. Brian Aragon still looking for his first world championship title.
That was rad. Stefan Alfano taking it right to the other skaters, upping the stakes with that 1080. We've seen so many 900s in this contest. That was the first 1080. In fact, a trick that you don't see very often on the Pro Tour.
Tough break for Brian Aragon, but he'll get many more attempts.
Here comes David Sizemore, backside alley, Unity across the sub box. Fakie 360 monkey plant over the spine, getting a little line out of this attempt.
Now, if I were Dave Sizemore, I would try to go back to what worked for him during the qualifiers, throw some big backflip variations, some of the more exciting stuff the crowd got behind.
Yes, which will do well with the crowd, but not necessarily so much so with the judges. Remember, here in the final round, it's all about getting that number one spot, so really, you've got to work on tricks that the judges will be able to score high, put you into one of those top spots. It's a very difficult trick
from Shima. He's getting closer, though. He's getting closer.
You know, and he did not use his first run, or his first attempt to get a trick under his belt. So he is staking a lot on that one very difficult trick right now. And look at Frankie back up on the vert ramp. We saw this in the semifinals where he transferred.
Oh,
wow, 540 attempt off of the deck of the vert ramp into the quarter pipe on the street course. Holy smoke, an amazing attempt from Frankie.
Well, he tried the 180 in qualifying, and that worked for him. Now upping it yet again. Now Stefano Alfano on fire.
Yeah, going 360 to the front side royale on the hitch and post. But, you know, after seeing that trick from Frankie, I got to feel like the rest of the riders in this heat have got to be thinking, you know, what are we going to do to compete with Frankie? And I bet all these guys in their minds are going back to the drawing board. 900 over the spine from Aragon.
Which, by the way, is much more difficult than doing a 900 over the launch box, because you've got to rotate so quickly to get your body back in the location where you can come down with your back lower than your feet.
360 front royale transfer. And then going over the hip with the alley-oop Savannah.
Well, the one thing that Dave Sizemore has going for him right now is he's landed some tricks. Some of these guys have not landed their tricks at all. They're going for broke and missing. Trying to lock on the sole, but he missed it.
Well, it's a matter of strategy at this point, Mark. I mean, because this is the final round, you don't really have to worry about playing it safe to try and keep advancing. Now is the time. If you've got one big trick in mind, why not spend the whole session just trying to nail it? Because if you do, that's how you get all the glory. That was close.
He got his back foot locked on and just couldn't get the front foot on.
Look, Frankie, back up on the vert ramp. This is so exciting. He came so close to landing that 540 transfer.
Perfect.
Oh, wow. I mean, perfect. No bobble on the landing. Perfect, solid landing.
Yeah, for risk and for difficulty and for danger, he is our leader right now. You can see the look on the Frenchman. Stefano Alfano knows he's got to step it up. Does not look pleased.
Well, like all these guys, you know they've got to be thinking, what are we going to do to compete with Frankie? And you can see the gears turning in Stefan's head.
Brian Aragon's got some big, big tricks as well. They're spinning up, but you've got to be able to rotate right back the opposite way without that hesitation.
And, you know, because of the way that this course is laid out, I mean, there's not a whole lot of opportunities to do stuff that big, not for these skaters. David Sizemore going 450 back royale down the handrail. But it's like, if you want to make an impression, if you want to compete with Frankie, you've almost got to, you know, use the same obstacles, because it's just, there's nothing else on this course big enough. Everything else right now, it looks like these guys are, you know, it's a different contest, the other guys versus Frankie right now.
Well, keep in mind, Stefano Alfano did land the huge 1080.
That's true.
That's a big, big trick. As far as the obstacles go, it's about as big as you're gonna get on anything else, so.
And you
we'll
put
see.
That 1080 up against Frankie's trick. I mean, what makes more of an impression? It's obviously Frankie.
Right.
And that's kind of my point. It's hard to compete on this course. So now what does Frankie do as an encore? How do you follow up that trick?
Interesting approach, going for the big grind. I mean, when in doubt in your Frankie Morales spin, the guy spins more fluidly than just about anybody else.
Well, you know,
now Stefano Fano's on top of
it. And you almost could have predicted this. I mean, how else are you going to compete with him?
Oh, boy. Well, and you know what that does? That shows you just how dangerous and just how hard it is. He went down hard.
That was a tough fall. And you know, really, if Stefan is going to really challenge Frankie right now for this top spot, which you've got to say is firmly in Frankie's grasp right now, if Stefan lands that trick, he's going to have to think of some way to actually one-up Frankie. It's not enough just to come out and do his trick. He's going to have to think of something bigger.
Kissing the sky, you know what that means. There's something big on his mind.
That's setting up for something here. 360 fronts, I saw. Oh, watch out!
There it is. I said that worked for him in qualifying. Why
the
not
money
go
maker.
Back? Go back to what works.
Stick with what got you there, right, Mark?
Listen, he launches all the way up above head high and then backflips down into the transition. If nothing else, you get the roar from the crowd.
No, I'm not taking anything away from him. I love Davey. He's an exciting skater, and you can definitely feel the energy picking up in this contest. I mean, it started with Frankie, and then Stefan, and now Sizemore. All these guys are definitely raising the level of competition here.
Well, and keep this in mind. I know you say it's all about the winner, but there's prize money at stake here. There's medals at stake. Every trick actually counts.
Yes, absolutely. But this is a best trick contest, and you can see it in the way these guys are skating now. None of them are skating for second or third place. They're going for the title right now, and that is the beauty of this kind of format.
And you know, it's interesting is Brian Shima has now gone for the same trick five times. He's missed five times, which means he's landed nothing. It's an all or nothing attitude he's got.
And after what we've seen from Frankie and Stefan, you've got to ask yourself, even if he lands it, where will it put him? And look at this, Frankie Morales still coming up with new tricks, a 900 acid drop all the way to flat.
Well, what did I say earlier? If you're Frankie Morales, spin. That's what you do best.
And look at Stefan still gunning for Frankie's trick. And he lands it, another perfect landing. So we've seen this amazing trick, and now Stefan is fired up.
The question is,
I don't know what that's all about. Is he doing that for Frankie's benefit, or is he really excited?
Well, in Stefan's mind, he's landed the same trick, but he also landed other cool tricks.
Like the 1080.
But it doesn't matter, because all that matters is the best trick. So he basically has matched Frankie's trick, but Frankie did it first. So then
he's got to figure out a way to one-up it.
Exactly. And so far, in my book, he hasn't one-upped it.
No, but he is. Whereas before it looked like Frankie was all alone out there, now he's got competition. This
Absolutely.
Is a real contest now.
And the Scotsman, Chaz Sands, going for another attempt. Missing yet again. So we really have a two-horse race right now as we come close to our final round.
Well, yeah, once we get through this round, we'll go back to the top of the order, and every skater will get one final attempt. So this will be Frankie's second to last attempt.
Frankie getting ready. And you know, I'm so impressed with what he's come up with in qualifying, then in the semifinals, and then here in the finals. He's stepped it up every single round, going for that 900, landing on his feet, not really riding away clean, but he gets one more attempt.
Yeah, he really has skated a perfect contest. I mean, he's built it from round to round, from heat to heat, keeps advancing and keeps saving something.
Yeah, and you saw him there heading back toward the vert ramp,
yes.
Just to put an exclamation point on it in case Stefano Fano steps it up.
That's exactly right, because nothing is a given at this point. And look at now Brian Aragon has gone up there. So, I mean, these guys are realizing that the way to compete in this contest, the only way, is to go for the biggest stunt out there, the biggest obstacle. And so now we're getting a crowd up on the deck of the vert ramp. And I don't know what Stefan's doing, because he should be up on the vert ramp. I don't know what.
This is real interesting to me. That was very French.
Well, it was also a throwaway.
Yeah.
I mean, he has not won this thing. I don't know why he thinks he doesn't need another attempt at this point.
It was funny. I mean, helmet flies off. Here we go, Brian Aragon. Ah, with that fall, Brian Aragon's chance at a world championship yet again will elude him. Some incredible skating today, but definitely not enough to beat Frankie Morales. So Dave Sizemore, definitely a crowd favorite with that big backflip. We'll see what else he's got for the final attempt here.
Front side, Farfignugan across the sub box. going for a 540 to kind grind up on the quarter pipe.
And that kid's got a bright future. The youngest out here, 19 years old. A great, great day for him.
He's got a bright helmet, too.
True that. Chaz Sands with some bright laces. We'll see what he's got.
Well, the judges will also have the task of sorting out all the places in this thing. As you mentioned, you know, it's not just about first place, although it seems to be among the skaters right now, but they're gonna have to figure out who's coming second and third here.
Well, I'm pretty certain that Brian Shima will finish in sixth out of six, because that go for broke attitude, you've got to admire, but he never landed a trick, so he walks away with pretty much a zero.
And on the opposite end of the spectrum, you've got Frankie Morales up here, who's landed a lot of tricks in this round, and he's still going for it. And you know, I just can't make sense of Stefan Alfano's last attempt. I mean, when the competition seems to be this close, and you've seen what Frankie's done, why would you take anything for granted?
Oh
man!
You know, I say give Frankie two more attempts, and he's gonna land that thing.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not gonna happen tonight, but I'll tell you, he can land that. He landed just a little bit too far up the transition.
And how about Chris Haffey in the stands? He didn't make the finals, but he's still out here supporting his buddies.
You saw that sign in the air, I vote Frank.
Yeah, you know, I think I do too. You know, Mark, I just don't get it. If Frankie thinks he can one-up himself and try the 900 off the rim, why wouldn't Stefan try it?
Well, here's our podium finishers. A great day for the youngster. David Sizemore taking home the bronze medal at the 2008 World Championships. There's your silver medalist, looking very unhappy at the moment, the Frenchman, Stefan Alfano. That is classy. Stefan Alfano, a gracious second place finish to our world champion, Frankie Morales. A fantastic finish and a dominant day all day long.
Amazing runs, a big win to cap off your year. What does this mean for you?
It's good, man. I was financially messed up right now. 10 G's is really good right now, so, you know, thanks, LG.
Talk to me a little bit about your fan club. You got a huge group of people that are screaming their head out for you every single run of yours.
Well, it just happens so every LG competition, I always get like either 11th or 12th and just make it. So this year they were all supportive, and Happy's really the one that always wins. He won 3 years in a row, and he's in my team, so he started the whole you know, thing. It was all good.
Party time tonight?
All day.
The inline skaters lit up the Key Arena. It's been some incredible skating here at the 2008 LG Action Sports World Championships, and some rockin' music on the Maxell Music Stage. Thank you for tuning in. To catch all the action and the highlights, go to lgactionsports.com. For Arlo Eisenberg and Zach Catfish Yankish, I'm Mark Shays. We'll catch you next time.